Back 10 minutes with the Bearcat. This week we got 10 minutes with the class of 2019. Our six juniors are here with us. I'll let them introduce themselves here and what we'll get going with. Some conversations about us on the court, them off the court, and just a deeper dive into who they are as the junior class. Intros.
My name's Charles Walker.
From?
Placentia, California.
I'm Jordan Jenkins, also from Placentia, California.
I'm Jameson Williams from Billings, Montana.
I'm Jeffrey Sutherland from Seattle, Washington.
Caleb Roberts, Salem, Oregon.
I'm Trent Callen from Portland, Oregon.
Excellent. So we're sitting here with these guys after a couple of days of practice has started. So the first question, we'll let TC start the answer here. First question, as a junior, what has stood out as a positive in this early part of practice?
Definitely from years before, I think we got out to a good start. There's always something you can improve, but just as a general first couple of days, it didn't look as sloppy as years in the past.
Scoops?
I'd definitely say energy. I feel like the two previous years, we kind of walked through like the first 30 minutes of practice, kind of warming up. But I mean, 10 minutes in, the whole team's dripping in sweat. So that's a good start to every practice.
JMO?
Yeah, I was going to say energy too. We've been a lot more sharp. Everybody's dialed in and focused to details more than we have been in the past.
CJ?
I would say competitiveness, especially in the CAT scrimmages, everyone's just out there getting after it.
Jeff?
I would say aggressiveness from everyone doing as much as they can. Like seeing even the freshmen like be aggressive on offense.
And I think you've taken more shots in the last 2 days than you had the first 2 years.
Caleb? I think the communication in the gym has been pretty good, and our defense has been a lot better than I've seen in the past.
Excellent. Okay, Scoops, you'll lead off with this one. One thing that you six as a group or maybe individually yourself, you can answer either way, that you think is going to be different this year and why?
I think, honestly, back to our energy, I think everybody is dialed into what we want to do as a team rather than just what we want to do individually, and I think that's going to be big for us this year.
TC?
I think that defensively, we can definitely get after it. We've had 2 years to kind of get down Joker, and I think this year we'll be a lot better at that.
JMO?
Communication, I think, has to step up and improve a lot just because we're going to demand that out of everybody, so there's going to be no excuses.
Caleb?
I think we have some ambitious players on the team this year. I think that we will see some people coming out of their shells and playing better than they have.
CJ?
I'm going to have to go back with what Jordan said, just the overall team buy-in on defense and offense. I mean, if we get that down, we're going to be good.
Seems Jeffrey.
A good one.
Yeah, I think for our class, everyone's ready to contribute in their own way.
Excellent. Now, think about yourself as a junior, thinking back to when you were a freshman or maybe even a sophomore. Is there a different mindset you bring once you're officially an upperclassman compared to before? Have you always carried this mindset? Talk to us a little bit about being a junior now on a team and being in a leadership role. JMO?
For me, it's definitely because I kind of lost last year, and so I went from being a newcomer freshman to now being upperclassman, and it's just kind of coming back from injury, a level of not taking things for granted and knowing that our time to get to play college basketball is kind of in its second half, and so taking advantage of every opportunity you get and definitely putting the time and the work in to do the most you can.
Scoops?
I'd definitely just say confidence. I mean, freshman year, I'm pretty sure all of us were pretty scared. Sophomore year, I mean, it was more natural, but it was still something new because not all of us really played all that much. But this year, I mean, we've all kind of seen a little bit of action, so it's for sure a different feel.
CJ?
Yeah, it's just a progression thing. Freshman year, just like Jordan said, I mean, the confidence, I mean, you're just starting out to play in college basketball. Sophomore year, it got better, and now we're juniors, we're upperclassmen. It's our time to go.
Jeff?
I think it's kind of like finding your roles over the first 2 years because like a lot of us come from like high school like where we were the guy and like learning to be a different role, a role player. Like you can like keep being the guy on this team. It's just finding your role. So.
TC?
Yeah, just kind of what Jordan and CJ said, confidence also for your freshman and sophomore year, just get a little unsure of where your place is, finding that role, and then being an upperclassman, a junior, senior just feels a little different than being a freshman or sophomore.
Caleb?
Yeah, I think we all are feeling more comfortable on the court, getting that exposure in games for the freshman and sophomore year. We're finally at that point where we feel comfortable going in games, taking your shot, driving to the basket, making the right play.
Excellent. Okay, off the floor now. Okay, take a minute. I'll give you a little bit of time. The first time you met as a group, or the first time you met each other individually, think back to those. And a couple of you, give me some stories of the first time this group got together. Because this group, for those of you listening, this group's pretty tight. Five women in a house. Jeffrey's been here with them for 3 years. Funny stories of first encounters. Okay, anybody can volunteer to go first.
Oh, sure.
It's J-Mo. Go ahead.
You ready? So when we all first met, my first impression of Trent was that he was just kind of a prick, not the nicest guy, but that's definitely changed, and now he's one of my best friends, so yeah.
Was that due to TC's lack of verbiage, of communication? Was he waving his hair actually?
Just kind of the hair flips.
He was always wearing a tank top in the
gym. Yeah, always wearing it, had to always be wearing a jersey whenever he was wearing working out in tank tops and stuff, and just
Portland school district.
T-shirts weigh you down.
Other guys.
I would say the first time I saw Jordan was at that camp, and I when I saw you, your physical appearance, I was not expecting the athleticism. I saw your jumper, but it was more of a set shot, and then I was like, oh, this guy's just a shooter maybe, and then you totally surprised me.
Yeah, that's a compliment in a way.
We've developed a little bit.
Yeah. I do remember the first camp that a lot of you guys were. I can't remember if everybody in this whole class worked the first camp, but J-Mo drove in from Billings, and I'm from Billings too, everybody listening. So I knew J-Mo, obviously, coming from the same high school as me. But you guys were all walking as a group, and poor J-Mo was sitting in this lobby looking at his schedule of what he had to do next. I was like, oh, crap. This Montana kid, they're not going to accept him. He's in trouble. Obviously, that worked out for everybody. Last question. Somebody shows up to campus. They listen to this. They love you guys. They want to meet you. 12:30 on any given day. Where is this group? Where are you individually? I have my ideas of where people might be. Where do you guys hang out on campus? What are you doing at that time frame during the day?
I'm at lunch in Conoco.
There you go.
Yeah, I'm also at lunch in Conoco.
Is that with your lunchbox, or are you actually getting food? Oh.
I get food on Wednesdays and Fridays because Katsudon is great. Katsudon is great.
Other guys.
Me and CJ have class together, so yeah. We're on our way to get some katsudon.
They're studying. See, they're in class learning.
We're eating, studying.
TC?
Class.
Class? Yeah. That's a normal at 12:30?
Usually, yeah.
Caleb?
Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and me and Jay are usually in the kitchen, cooking and talking.
Yeah.
How is that? What have you learned as the five of you that are roommates? What have you learned about each other?
Our kitchen is too small.
The kitchen is too small?
Oh, I got a good one. Jordan loves leaving the bathroom light on.
So does J-Mo.
So does J-Mo. That's
CJ
not
takes very long showers.
Yeah, CJ's probably half our water bill.
Does that affect the utilities bill a little bit?
Nah.
No, it's clean. That's
not really.
Like a nice steamy shower. It's good.
And Caleb loves using towels when he cleans things.
There's lots of sink.
There's always dish towels.
He doesn't use a sponge.
Yeah.
He will use a towel to clean the dishes.
Well, we have
a
sponge.
We have the same sponge to rinse, clean.
No, we
don't.
No, we don't.
You know you can buy those sponges now that are dishwasher. You can put them in the dishwasher.
We have those.
You got those.
Yeah, we have those, but Caleb just likes using the rags.
Anyways.
We also learned that there are always a lot of dishes in the sink, and they belong to nobody.
There's no schedule right now, chore list in the house or anything?
No.
Not right.
It was empty when I finished cooking last night, and I went out there this morning.
Oh, man.
The whole kitchen's filled with dishes.
I was ready to send a message to everybody.
What is the meal of choice? You guys cook together or individually? This is my cupboard, my food.
Mostly
individually.
Jameson loves Mexican food. He loves himself some Mexican food.
Caleb loves burgers.
Okay. Barbecue? George Foreman style? What do you got?
Barbecue?
Gas Grill.
Gas Grill?
Yeah.
Okay. Excellent. 10 minutes, class of 2019, the juniors. Catch it audio or on YouTube.